What is going on, you guys? Welcome back to Universe Mode. This is going to be episode 14, I do believe. I'm going to check right now. We are 3 weeks away from the Payback pay-per-view, Raw exclusives pay-per-view. We have the Raw Intercontinental Championship going on. This is the first match. Sorry, I had to grab my paper real quick. This is the second round matchups. We got Samoa Joe taking on Chris Jericho. I think Cesaro and Hideo Itami is going to be fighting, and then I'm not sure if Big Show and Daniel Bryan is fighting, but we got that going on. And then we got the match between Naomi and Nia Jax. The winner of that will go on to face Trish Stratus. And the winner of that match will then be the Raw Women's Champion. So I'm going to try and... I'm going to wait for that match for Payback. And then we still got the Universal Championship Tournament going on. Let me go ahead and pull that up for you. Finn Balor is in the lead with 8. And later on tonight, he is going on against Baron Corbin, who has no points on the board yet. And AJ Styles is taking on Nakamura. So so let's go ahead and get this first match started without wasting any more time. And here we go, the match is underway. Chris Jericho taking on Samoa Joe. The winner of this will go on to the next round of the Intercontinental Championship Tournament for Monday Night Raw. And pretty soon, guys, I'm going to be figuring out a way to get myself a tower for my computer, as you guys know. And, once that happens, I'll be able to use my Elgato. So that'd be awesome. And plus, I got some, other things I need to share with you guys as well, but I'm not going to do it during the universe mode. It'll be like its own little video. But right now, Samoa Joe and Chris Jericho are battling back and forth. Samoa Joe with the reversal. In an NXT TakeOver Toronto, Samoa Joe and Shinsuke Nakamura fought for the NXT Championship, and Samoa Joe is now the first ever two-time NXT champion. Because he defeated Shinsuke Nakamura for the championship. I was really hoping Nakamura was going to win, but Joe took it back. So Joe is now the NXT champion again. But I think it's this week on Wednesday. there's either going to be like a contract signing or something like that for the... not contract signing, but like a, I don't know. I think either Samoa Joe's going to return after the victory in Toronto, or it's going to be Nakamura that returns. I can't really remember. But right now, Samoa Joe is in firm control of this matchup against Chris Jericho. But Jericho with the reversal. And Samoa Joe with the roll-up one. But Jericho's in the ropes to cause a rope break. And Samoa Joe with a pin. 2, 3. And just like that, Samoa Joe advances. So once again, with another stupid-ass ending to a match, I'm really getting tired of that. Where the way it freaking with the superstars end the matchup in this game, like in 2K17 for the PS4, they actually try their best, but in this one they just go for any pin possible. But Samoa Joe nonetheless advances, and he'll be either facing Daniel Bryan or The Big Show next week on Monday Night Raw. Now it's time for the Dudley Boys to defend their World Tag Team Championships against The Revival. Alright, the World Tag Team Championships on the line. The Dudley Boys won the entire tournament when Raw announced it. And The Revival are the number one contenders. So they get their shot here on Monday Night Raw tonight. And then last week, if you guys remember, on Monday Night Raw, we found out who our Raw general manager is, and The Rock. And then on SmackDown Live, Stone Cold Steve Austin was the SmackDown Live general manager, so that's pretty awesome. I think this is Scott Dawson in the, yeah, Scott in the ring right now. Then that's Bubba Ray Dudley. And also at NXT TakeOver Toronto, The Revival lost their championships to Joey Gargano and Tommaso Ciampa in a 2 out of 3 falls match. The Revival was the SmackDown, NXT champions, and then The Revival finally got their shot. The Tommaso Ciampa and Johnny Gargano finally got their shot, and they defeated The Revival. Every time I do a Universe Mode video, I always mess up talking. I'm sorry about that, guys. Right now, Bubba Ray Dudley tagged in D-Von. Scott Dawson tagged in Dash Wilder. Irish up into the corner. Oh, what a move from D-Von. Looked like he was copying The Rock right there, but hard Irish whip into the corner again. But D-Von with the reversal. Dash Wilder now in firm control of the Dudley Boys. But now D-Von with the reversal. With the go behind. Russian leg sweep taking down Dash Wilder. And now choking him. Remember, this is for the World Tag Team Championships. And now Dash getting out of the ring, tagging in Scott. Big elbow drop from D-Von Dudley. Oh, what a clothesline from Scott Dawson. Now D-Von just choking Scott relentlessly. This is an incredible matchup so far. But look at that, both the teammates go and tag their other partners. And Dash just with a forearm shot. Oh, Dash going for a dirty pin. One. Two. It's, man, that ref. The feet are on the ropes. Got a jam-packed crowd here tonight for Monday Night Raw. What a neck break, with a backbreaker slash neckbreaker type maneuver from Dash Wilder. Dash going for the pin. One, two. Oh, and Devon takes out the ref, so Bubba Ray was able to kick out. Bubba now. Big power bomb. Big slap to the chest. Now Dash looking to tag in Scott, but he couldn't get there. Double axe handle now on the back. Overhead belly-belly suplex. Both these two teams have a devastating tag team finishing maneuver. The Dudley Boys have the 3D, and Scott Dawson and Dash Wilder, the Revival, have the Shatter Machine. If one of these two teams use their finishing maneuver, you know it's got to be over. Now the Revival, big kick to the knee. Now they're working on the knees of Devon. Smart strategy. Now Dash with the roll up, but he didn't go for the pin. Double axe handle again. Oh, Devon, I mean, going for a submission. And Bubba breaks it up. Devon, go for the pin. One. Two, and Scott breaks it up. Bubba couldn't get out because he was trapped. Oh, Devon's just throwing haymakers left and right. Reversal from Dash. And Dash Wilder with the maneuver. Oh my goodness. That's a incredible maneuver. Going for the pin now. One. And Bubba breaks it up. What is Dash looking for here? Big clothesline to the back of the head. Going for the pin. We're going to have new tag team champions. One, two, no. And Bubba saves the matchup again. Codebreaker. Out of nowhere. Dash going for the pin. One, two. And no, Bubba Ray saves it again. Man, this match would have been over. We would have new tag team champions here on Monday Night Raw. Devon with a spinning elbow. Going for the pin. One, two, 3, and we still got the tag team champions in the Dudley Boys. Dudley Boys still tag team champions here on Monday Night Raw. It was another weird ending to the match, but it's all over now. Bubba Ray and D-Von are still the world tag team champions. It is now time for some women's action here, as Naomi is taking on Nia Jax. The winner of this will go on to face Trish Stratus for the Raw Women's Championship. Nia Jax defeated both the Bella Twins. Naomi defeated Becky Lynch and Asuka to get to where they are. Trish Stratus got a bye in the first week. She defeated Paige. She got a bye in the second week because she didn't have no opponent to face her. And now she is waiting and watching in the back to see who her opponent is going to be next week on Monday Night Raw. A couple weeks from now at Payback. But Naomi holding her own against the dominant force that is Nia Jax. Naomi with these vicious elbows. And again, she took Nia down, but Nia was able to spring back and get back up on her feet. I was really surprised when Naomi defeated Asuka. That was pretty impressive. Naomi working on the legs of Nia Jax. Big Bulldog taking Nia down. Oh my lord. Big drop kick to the knee. Flooring Nia. Oh, and Nia Jax just like that. Big power bomb. My goodness. Running STO now from Nia Jax. Nia Jax, spine buster. Samoa drop. Oh my god, I cannot talk, guys. I'm so sorry. Samoa drop from Nia Jax. Big enziguri now from Naomi. Naomi working on those legs still of Nia Jax, trying to keep her floored. Big hurricanrana. Another hurricanrana from Naomi, taking Nia down. Oh, big kick to the face. Power ship into the corner. Split leg moonsault from Naomi. Dragging Nia Jax away from the ropes. Going for the pin. Is Naomi going to move on to face Trish Stratus? No. Nia Jax kicks out. But Naomi just planted Nia Jax. 1, 2, 3. What an upset. What an upset for Naomi. She first defeats Asuka. And now she defeats Nia Jax. And she's going on to face Trish Stratus at the Payback pay-per-view. Man, Naomi has some good luck on her side. And here we go, guys, with some more of the Universal Championship Tournament. Finn Balor honestly shouldn't even be competing because he's in the lead. He has 8 points. But Baron Corbin has to figure out a way to get some points somehow. He already lost against Nakamura. He lost against AJ Styles. And Finn Balor was the only person What a maneuver from Finn Balor. And Finn Balor had a change of heart recently. So he's not the same Finn Balor as we all know. But Baron Corbin, if he can at least figure out some way to get some points on the board, then he'll still have a chance in this tournament. Because if he loses to Finn Balor here tonight, come next week on Monday Night Raw, he will no longer be in the tournament. He will be eliminated. Even though I said we are 3 weeks away from payback, but after this, if Baron Corbin loses to Finn Balor, he is going to be eliminated. So all Baron has to do in this match is to either knock out Finn Balor, get 4 points, win by submission. If he wins by countout, he'll still be in. Or if he wins by disqualification somehow, he'll still have a chance. But if he pins Finn Balor, that'll give him 4 points. So next week on Monday Night Raw, he'll then face Nakamura, depending on what happens in the main event. Because in the main event, it is going to be Nakamura and AJ Styles, I do believe. Oh my goodness, what a maneuver from Baron Corbin. Overhead belly belly suplex. Finn Balor with a reversal. Big kick to the back. Sling blade from Finn Balor. Another sling blade from Finn. Baron with the reversal. Another overhead belly belly suplex. Repeated punches to the face now. And now kicks. Balor with the reversal. Hard ass whip into the corner. Baron going for the pin. 1, 2, 3. And Baron Corbin gets 4 points just like that. So Baron Corbin was not messing around tonight. He just took it right to the street to Finn Balor, giving himself 4 points. So now Baron has to wait and see what happens later on tonight between Nakamura and AJ Styles. Here we go with some more Raw Intercontinental Championship tournament action as Cesaro takes on Hideo Itami. What should be an incredible matchup. Itami now just going right after Cesaro. But Cesaro with the German suplex. Itami with the reversal. Throwing Cesaro into the post. Oh my goodness. Big stomp to the stomach to Cesaro. The winner of this will either face Zack Ryder or John Cena next week on Monday Night Raw. Well, a couple weeks from now on Monday Night Raw, it'll either be Zack Ryder, because next week it's going to be Zack Ryder facing John Cena. And then the week after that, it's going to be Cesaro or Hideo Itami taking on Zack Ryder or John Cena. Then we got Big Show and Daniel Bryan, so the winner of that match will then face Samoa Joe. So at Payback, it's going to be a long episode. Well, not long episode, but it's going to be like multiple parts. Cesaro's attacking a ref. I think he was just trying to get a Tommy, but the ref is in the way. Tommy going to the top rope. Big elbow drop. Going for the pin. One, two, three. Oh, man. Cesaro kicking out. What an uppercut from Cesaro. Oh, Cesaro with the reversal. Big neck breaker. I'm not really sure what Hitami was going for, but Cesaro reversed. Irish up into the corner now. Oh, big kicks to the stomach of Cesaro. Hitami takes him down in the corner. Hitami again with the alley-oop bomb. What a suplex neckbreaker type maneuver from Cesaro. Oh, Itami! Itami! What a combination of maneuvers. Big kick to the stomach. Itami now dragging Cesaro away from the ropes. Cesaro with his comeback. He popped up. Oh, Cesaro. Oh my goodness, what uppercuts. And here we go with the uppercut train. Oh my lord. Big drop kick. Itami! No, no, no. Oh my goodness. Go to sleep! Go to sleep! Itami, one, two, three, and Itami just showed the rest of the competitors of how to win a match. That is how you win a match, ladies and gentlemen, with your finishing maneuver, not some stupid roll-up or something like that after a single move. Itami just proved that he has the right to become Intercontinental Champion. He is why I believe The Rock picked him for Monday Night Raw. I mean, that is seriously how you win a match. With your finishing maneuver, go for the pin, and it's over. Not, you know what I mean? But Hideo Itami, nonetheless, advances in the Raw Intercontinental Championship tournament. And here we go, guys. This is the main event. Shinsuke Nakamura, AJ Styles. The winner of this will get some more points on the board. Well, Styles went for a springboard moonsault DDT, but he missed. A Nakamura single leg drop kick. What a faint kick from Nakamura. Big DDT from AJ Styles. What a maneuver. Oh man, what a maneuver from AJ Styles. Lion Salt. Nakamura, powerbomb! Oh my goodness! Alright, you guys, so AJ Styles has 3 points. Oh, Nakamura setting him up. Big knee to the gut! Oh my goodness! Oh, that has to hurt. AJ Styles has 3 points. He defeated Baron Corbin by a submission. And then Shinsuke Nakamura has 4. And now Baron Corbin has 4. And Nakamura with a German suplex. So can AJ Styles get some more points on the board, or will it be Shinsuke Nakamura getting some points on the board? We're going to find out. Baron Corbin was able to keep himself alive in this tournament as he defeated Finn Balor in just destruction. A big DDT from AJ Styles. Oh my goodness. German suplex from Nakamura. What is this now? Oh my goodness, Nakamura, what is... Oh! Look like an arm breaker. Could have broke AJ's arm. No wonder they call him the King of Strong Style. Pele kick! Pele kick! Take Nakamura down. AJ! Ooh. Went for another Lion Salt, but he missed. Didn't get all of it. Big elbow drop to the back of the head. Big clothesline. Who's going to win this match and get some more points on the board for themselves in this Universal Championship tournament? But AJ going for the pin. 1, 2. Nope, Nakamura kicked out at 1. Oh my goodness, what a spinning back fist from Nakamura. Looked like it just knocked AJ's lights out, but AJ's back up fighting. Big knee. Nakamura with the reversal. AJ Styles with the reversal with a roll up. 1, 2. And Nakamura. 1, 2. AJ. 1. What is this now from AJ? German suplex from Nakamura. And Nakamura going for it again. Nakamura's going for it again. Oh! That's gotta hurt. Oh, Nakamura setting him up. Exploder suplex. One. Two. And AJ kicks out. What is Nakamura looking to do here? AJ throwing it a bit outside. This is your main event of the evening, guys. Oh, Nakamura, he's setting it up. Big clothesline. Come on, Nakamura. Come on, Nakamura. Don't waste time. Don't waste time. Kinshasa! Going for the pin. One, two, three, and Nakamura. Ooh, and Nakamura gets more points on the board. And just like that, Nakamura picking up 4 points over AJ Styles. And now Nakamura and Finn Balor are tied at 8. So next week on Monday Night Raw, it is going to be Baron Corbin taking on AJ Styles. And the loser of that match will be out of the tournament. But Nakamura with 8 points now. He is tied with Finn Balor. Well, guys, that is it for Monday Night Raw. We'll see you on SmackDown Live.